Well, everybody, we just wrote down all of our PAWS rules for art class and drew 4 PAWS because we're being inspired by Andy Warhol and his artwork called the Maryland Diptych. And we are now going to start using our oil pastels. So you'll be allowed to use whichever colors you want. Let's go ahead and pick out our first color. So just pick out any color that you would like. You can make it look like this if you want. I'm going to leave this here the whole time in case you wanted to be inspired by this specific one. I think I will go ahead and start with orange. And grab your color. We are first going to outline the top left paw. Top left paw. So get a color to outline your top left paw. Alrighty, and now we're all going to outline our top left paw. So you're just going to go over your pencil line. And it's okay that the pencil is showing through. It's kind of nice there. And notice I'm kind of going over it a couple times. Okay, those are the ovals. And now let's outline. This is called the pad of the paw. We're trying not to get any of this on our hands. So when you are going over, like if you have to have your hand on a part that you've already oil pasteled, just kind of lift your hand up a little bit and kind of float your hand over it. There you go. Okay. We can try to make the outline look really nice and even. And the same thickness all the way across. All the way throughout. Okay, we good? All right, and then you can put that oil pastel back. And let's go ahead and pick out our next color. I think I'm going to do yellow for the inside of mine. And now we're gonna color the inside of our artwork. Okay, there's one, two. And these two colors will blend together a little bit. Three. Okay, so we've done, these are called the toe beans. So toe beans done. And now we're coloring the inside of that paw. And I kind of like to do these swirly lines in order to fill it up. Girls. It's all filled up. There we go. And then put that color away. You should be done filling it in. And like we said in our objectives, we are going to explore the oil pastel technique that is blending with fingers. So if you'd like to go ahead and grab your pointer finger or a pinky, whichever finger you want, you can just kind of blend it together a little bit. So blend those two colors together if you would like to. And these like little oil pastel type of like boogery things, you can just set those on the table. Almost done with blending. There we go. And so we'll look a little something like that. So it doesn't blend like the chalk pastels, does it? It's more of a textured blend versus like a very soft blend. So it gives a nice texture look to it. Good. Okay. Now let's, I'm actually going to zoom in a little bit so you guys can see the texture of it. There. Okay. So now we are going to do the background of it, and I'll show you this in case some of you guys are looking at this as inspiration. Okay, so now go ahead and pick out a color for your background of this top right artwork. I'm going to do this blue. And what we're going to do is we are going to not color where our words are. So see how I'm just drawing a line above my words here? And a line below my words up here, like so. And notice how when I get all the way to the edge of the paper, I'm not coloring on my table. I'm lifting my paper up a little bit. And I can kind of go like this. And that's one way I can color the edge of my artwork without getting on the table. Another way is to, I find that doing these like swirly lines in order to color something in, it also helps with when you get to the edge. Whereas if you're going back and forth like this, it's really easy to accidentally go off your paper and get oil pastel on the table. So let's not get oil pastel on the table. Let's do these swirly lines as we get on the edge. Let's all paint the, or color the edge. Or like I said, you can lift up and go that way. Now, once you're done with the edge, then you are welcome to go back and forth. So we are now all coloring the background of our top left paw section. So that's what you should be doing right now. And I'm going to go ahead and put some music on for us. Alrighty, there we go. You guys should be done coloring the background of this paw. And now put that oil pastel back. And now you can blend. You can pick a different finger if you want. I think I'm going to pick this other pointer finger. And now you can use your finger to blend all of that color in. So you can look and see the difference here. And there was a little bit of like my yellow and my orange on my background here. And so, what does yellow and blue make? It makes green. So you'll notice that some of my sections have a little bit of green on them now, which is kind of cool. So we're just kind of embracing how it's not perfectly smooth. The colors are blending together a little bit. There we go. I'll turn the music up while we blend that. We're just trying to get rid of all the white spots. There we go. All right, you guys, awesome. This is looking really cool. Okay, so now we're gonna do our next paw here. So go ahead, I'll show you guys this in case you're using it for inspiration. Oh, I guess I did one really similar to this, but instead of pink and yellow, I did orange and yellow, didn't I? Okay, so go ahead and pick out your outline for your next paw. The top right corner is what we're doing next. Actually, yeah, that's fine. The top right corner we're gonna do next. So pick out a color for that. I think I'm gonna do a green outline. And make sure that you don't have any oil pastels out except for the one in your hand. And now we're going to outline our next paw. I'll turn the music on while we trace our pencil lines. Hope you guys are enjoying this lesson. I'm having a lot of fun. coloring. Okay, you should be done outlining. So now put that away and get out another color. So a color that you think would blend really well with your outline. So usually the warm colors and the cool colors look really good together. So let me show you. This is the color wheel here. And, so these warm colors on this left side, yellow, orange, and red, these usually blend really well together. So notice how my orange and yellow look good together. And these colors over here blend really well together too. So I did green this time, so I'm probably gonna blend it with one of these colors on this side. If you blend colors opposite of each other, these are called complementary, like yellow and purple, that's gonna turn brown. Orange and blue, that's gonna turn brown. Red and green will turn brown too. Those are complementary. So I'll leave this here for you to look at. So anyway, I'm going to use a cool color for mine personally, but you can pick whatever color you want. I'm going to do this blue here. All right, now we have picked up our oil pastel for our inside of our paw color, and we're going to color that in now. Okay, now it's time to blend. So I have a finger that has cool colors and a finger that has warm colors. What do you think I'm gonna wanna blend with? This one, right? Because if I blend with this one that already has those warm colors, it might turn a little muddy. So we're gonna do this one here. You guys can go ahead and pick whatever finger you want to blend with. And this blending kind of gives it a little bit of a texture as well, right? So it's fun to learn lots of different techniques here. So this one adds a lot of texture to your art. Okay, and I'm going to blend in here. There we go. And it kind of lightens it up a little bit too, right? Because some of the pigment, the color gets on your finger. So it's kind of cool. And some of the little oil pastel comes off of it. That's okay. You can kind of, I just like to kind of roll them all together as much as I can. And then maybe just set them on my table for now. And then at the end of class, we can pick all the little, I call them oil pastel boogers, all the little oil pastel boogers and toss them in the trash. Okay, good. So now go ahead and pick out your background color for the top right corner of your art. So I kind of did this one, but backwards, didn't I? I keep doing it like the example, and I don't even mean to. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and turn the volume up, and we're going to now color the background of our top right paw. You guys are doing really good. Keep up the good work. I forgot. We need to do our line. Let's draw a line that goes above the bottom words. Again, careful not to get it on the table when we draw lines. And a line that goes underneath the top words. And now let's color the right edge together doing either our swirly technique or our lift the paper technique. Okay, there we go. Now I'll turn the music on and let you guys color the rest. And notice how I'm not worried about having these little tiny white spaces because I know the next step is to blend. And when we blend, we fill in all those little white spots, right? So put your background oil pastel away. And now we are actually going to do a little hand stretching here. So I'm just going to have you, let me zoom out so you can see. So go ahead and take your right hand, put it out, and then take your left hand and kind of, you're just going to very gently pull it back like this. And if yours only goes to here, that's fine. If it goes to here, that's fine. Mine goes back pretty far. But you don't want to force it. So go ahead and start stretching with me. I'm just holding my fingers down here. And I'm just very gently applying a little bit of pressure, but it should not hurt. If it hurts, then you're going too far back. And then we're going to do the opposite of that. We're going to take our fingers up and pull them back a little bit towards you. Okay. Very good. Okay. Now let's do the other hand. So put your left hand out. Hold it. Hold your fingers back with your right hand. Again, very gentle. Yours could be here. That's fine. I don't want you to hurt yourself. So be very gentle. Don't push that back. Don't pull back too hard. And then I'm going up. Let's go up now. Good. And down. And up. That should feel really good. It shouldn't hurt. If it hurts, you're pushing too far. Now we're going to do another stretch. I'm going to have you guys put your fingers together like so. And then flip your hand and just push out a little bit. Very gentle. And you can kind of roll your thumbs around as well. Good, and you kind of stretch each finger a little bit. Good job. Okay, and then you just kind of shake your hands. All right, that should feel really, really good. You can give yourself a little hand massage if you want. Just taking care of our hands. These are very important. This is what we make art with. So we got to take good care of our hands. All right, awesome, you guys. Now, we only have two left. Oh, first we have to blend this one, don't we? So let's go ahead and, again, you might have a finger with cool colors and a finger with warm colors like me. Or you can pick a brand new finger. You could pick your pinky or something if you want to blend with a different finger. I'm just going to use my same cool color finger here. And I know that I might get some blue on my purple, but that's okay with me. We're embracing like the blending of the colors. Okay, so all that being said, I'll turn on music and we're now going to blend with our finger our background of this top right paw. All these like little, I call them oil pastel boogers. We'll worry about that at the end. Okay, now let's do our bottom left. I'll show you guys this in case you're using this as inspiration here. Oh, I essentially did this one, except for I did, anyway, blah, blah. You guys don't need to hear me talk about my art. You just wanna look at this and pick a color. I'm gonna do, I already did a yellow, I already did a blue. Maybe I will do a purple. Yeah. Purple. And we are, of course, going to outline. Well, you know what? I want this for my base. No, I'm going to do purple for my outline. Okay, grab a color for your outline. Let's go. Time to pick out a color for the middle. I'm gonna do blue. And let's color the middle of our paw. It's blending time. Blend those two colors together. It's background time. Pick out a background color. Draw a line on the top of your bottom letters or words. Draw a line under your top words. And let's do the edge carefully together. and you may now color the rest of your background. Remember, we're going gently with this, so if you push down really hard and fill in all the little white spots, you're going to wear down the oil pastel, and we're going to run out of oil pastels. So we just want to go very gently so we don't use too much of it, and then you'll still have some white spaces there. Put that background color away, and now we can go ahead and blend, and that will fill in all the white spaces there so it looks more finished. So we're blending our white spaces away, and it's really cool because we get some of those colors from our last artworks on it because it was on our finger. So I'm getting some oranges and yellows on there, which is really cool because I still have some color left over from this one up here. So let's go ahead and blend our background. These little oil pastel boogers are probably driving you nuts. We've got one more, and then I'll let you guys take them to the trash can, dump the oil pastel boogers out, like always, and then wash our hands, just like we do with our chalk pastels. All right, so pick out a color for your outline for your last one. Okay, let's see. I'm gonna do red this time. All right, let's outline our last one. Let's pick our inside color. I'm gonna do orange. Inside color and go. Blending time. Let's check and make sure there's no oil pastels on our desk. They should all go where oil pastels go, because we don't want to be hogging one of the colors. Time to blend. Thank you. to pick out a background color. I'm picking yellow. Draw a line above your words at the bottom of your section. Draw a line under your words on your top section. And carefully color the edge. And now we can color the rest. Time to blend. Okay, if I call your table, line up at the trash can with your art and pour the oil pastel boogers into the trash can, and then put your artwork on my desk, and then go to the bathroom, wash your hands. Unless there's already two people washing their hands, then stand outside of the bathroom next to the wall and wait your turn. Then once you wash your hands, come back in and go sit in the waiting room, and your teacher will be here to get you soon. So don't play in the bathroom. You just soap, scrub your two little fingers, because that's all that should be dirty, our two little fingers. Rinse in the water, dry real quick on the dryer, but it's just two fingers, so you could probably just pat it on your pants if you want. But come back in, sit in the waiting room, play on a art toy, or read an art book while you wait for your teacher to get here. Awesome job, you guys. Can't wait to see how these turn out. I'll see you in the next video. Bye.